Hey everyone, it's Dan from First Person Looter playing the sixth video for Days Gone. And let's check the good, and it works. Probably not going to be able to talk much. And there's me checking my stream right there. This is where we're at. Gonna probably not talk much. Not sure how much time I'll have to play this game. We'll see. I started adding descriptions of the quote-unquote plot. Because obviously it's open world and you can do whatever you want, really. So the plot, my particular plot, is not the same as someone else's plot, perhaps. But go check that out. I'm gonna try to not talk so much. And, PlayStation fan is crazy loud, and I don't know how long I'll be allowed to play this. I'm sure I'm going to get stopped at some point, but let's just get right into it. I'm going to click the mic off, and yeah, we're doing You're Safe Now.
Didn't know if you were coming back or not.
Hey, you know I wouldn't leave you out here.
Jack used to say the best alarm clock was the sun shining on chrome.
Jack used to say a lot of stupid shit. Yeah, that's right. I gotta burn out the rest of these nests. Gotta be close to a nest. Whew, I can smell it. Somewhere. I would need water. Maybe down by the creek. Gotta look around. Muddy tracks. Kid size, women's. Oh, fuck, Boozer would know. Hers. This must be where she comes to get water. Yeah, you come here for water every day, don't you? But you move cautiously. You don't stick around long. Good for you. There we go. At last. Smart girl. Stay off the street. Only come out at night. The freakers are out, but she'd be harder to see. None of you are getting out of here alive.
Oh, yeah. Sorry, goddammit. Spread out, look around. There's a girl here somewhere.
Hit him down. I'm moving back. Thank you.
Come on, come on.
These.
Thank you.
What the hell?
Sealed up. How'd she get in and out? Gotta set it here. All right, kid. Where are you hiding? Don't be afraid. I'm not gonna hurt you. Are you alone? Is there, anyone else with you? Oh, man. Okay, Is this your room? It's really great. Are these yours?
No!
Lisa.
That's mine. This one's for gymnastics. I should have won first place, but Missy King, she cheated.
Lisa! Lisa, you hear the gunshots outside? It's not safe here.
School. And my mom called me and told me to come home right away and not stop. And they would be here waiting for me and we would leave together and... I got here and there was a note that said they left with some men, and I didn't know what to do, so I hid. I didn't know what to do.
It's all right. It's okay. Lisa, not far from here, there's a camp. And you really ought to let me take you there.
No.
There are people there. There are people. I know them. I'm not going to lie to you. It's a work camp, and to eat, you have to work. Life is going to be hard.
No.
But at least you ain't going to starve.
No. No, my mom's coming here for me.
Okay, is this your mommy? Well, you said she didn't come home, right? So maybe she's at the camp.
Mom is at the camp. I know she is.
Okay. Stay close.
The men with the guns. Are they still out there?
No, we don't gotta worry about
them. Lots of sick people.
Bounties.
Go.
Oh. Get on. We have to move.
I don't know about this.
Come on, kid. We gotta go.
Okay. Hey, what's your name?
Deacon. My name's Deacon. Lisa. Lisa, how did you live out here alone for all this time?
My dad's a rock hound. He used to take me out here looking for thunder eggs.
Thunder eggs? What is that?
They're rocks, but when you cut them open, they're really pretty inside.
Okay. That sounds great.
We used to go all over. Belknap Crater, the lava flow and Black Crater, everywhere. Do you think he's at the camp too?
I don't know, kid. Someone's in the tunnel.
What?
Here, hop off.
What are we doing?
Listen to me. The gunshots that you heard, those were really bad men. Do you understand? Something out of this.
Now I got you.
Stay here, find some place to hide. Don't come out until I say so, okay?
Get to me now!
Lisa! Kid! Come on out, it's safe! You okay?
Yeah. I think I want to go home.
Nah, kid, the cab. You'll be safe there, you'll see.
Okay.
I'm gonna ask you a question, Lisa, and I need you to think real hard. Did any of your neighbors, did they own any firearms, you know, like pistols, rifles, things like that?
No. Men came and took everything.
Men? Were they like the men in the tunnel, or did they wear uniforms like in the army?
Like the army. But they were really dirty, and they carried flags they made themselves. Deschutes County Militia, I think. I don't remember.
They have anyone with them? Women? Children?
I don't remember.
Okay.
Tommy would remember.
Tommy?
Tommy Strictland. My best friend. But he's gone. He left with his dad to hide.
Hide? I don't...
His dad built a fallout shelter and put all kinds of stuff in it. Maps, food, water, guns, you know. Stuff like that.
Okay, do you know where that is?
No. They wanted me to come with them. but I knew my mom and dad would come back for me.
Someone's at the gate.
All right, this is it. We're here, wait, so just okay. Stay with me.
Open up.
Okay.
Well, who do we have here?
Mrs. Tucker.
Oh, my God. Lisa, honey. It's okay. You're safe now.
Mom and Dad and everyone got sick and I didn't know what to do. And men came and people got sick. And...
It's okay. You're safe now. It's a miracle. It's a goddamn miracle. We were neighbors, weren't we, Lisa? I lived just down the block. I knew her parents.
Are they here, Mrs. Tucker?
Honey, you know the answer to that.
No. They're not here.
Let's go in. Get you cleaned up. Something to eat, and then I'll find a place for you to sleep. Take her in. Give her some food. Go see Alkai. I'll update your credits tonight.
Hey, listen. She's been through a lot. Can we just...
Let me worry about how...
No, listen to me, okay? Seriously, don't work her like you do everyone else.
Don't tell me how to run my camp. You want to move here? You want to help us run this? Then maybe you get some say. Don't get soft on me, Dee.
Can I help you?
How you doing?
Okay.
What are you looking for? All right, I see how it is. See you around.
Hey, man.
Just having a look.
It's your bike, right? Come back soon.
Hey, what do you need? Can I help you?
Hey, how's it going?
Okay, then. See ya.
Let me get the gate.
How's life in this shit?
How's it going?
What's going on,
looks
huh?
Looks like you got a few ears here.
Hey, I haven't seen Boozer around much lately.
Yeah, he's around. I guess he's just been doing more work for Copeland lately.
You tell him I said get off his ass and do some work for me.
Yeah, I'll let him know.
Got some bounties. That's good. It's real good.
That's all I got.
Sure. Stop by soon.
Think we're gonna run out?
Best not to ask questions.
That's it.
Here for your bike?
Hey, just taking a look.
How's it going?
Hey, what's up?
Let me get the gate.
Boozer, that's amazing.
Yeah, I do need some. Deacon out. Tucker, okay. I'll stop by when I can. Deacon out. Later, finish burning out these nests. There.
Sarge, how about we make an unscheduled stop on our way back? A couple of sample traps I want to check.
Hey, Doc, how long before your job's done?
I'm not a doctor. I keep telling you that.
Sorry, we've been there, Brian. How long are we going to be here?
Thanks, brother. I thought I saw something in our approach. I'm going to check it out. Lieutenant O'Brien, field note 2006. On approach to the landing site, I observed a large swarm of insects, probably Tabanisatratus or Diptera, in a clearing well away from our designated target. From that distance, I could not discern what was attracting the insects, but from the size of the swarm, recent carrion is indicated. Should be just over here. Speculation as to Tabanisatratus is confirmed. Lots of force flies here. But I have the suit on me, too. Carrion is still mostly intact. And
you
hear
that?
Appears to be what, a corvius, a lioness, or mule deer. As if anybody could check that. Striation of the larger muscle masses indicate infection of strain HB. We'll take sample to confirm.
Look at it this way, you poor son of a bitch. At least you weren't torn apart by freaks. If you lived a few more weeks, you might have become one yourself. And would have happened something. What do you want? Stay back.
I just want to talk.
Nero, Protocol 2-7 states clearly that if conducting operations in quarantine zones, if I encounter any civilians or civilians that I'm forbidden from making contact.
Really? See, that sounded to me like making contact.
Yes. Yes, it did.
You're alive.
Yes. I am.
How? How are you alive,
O'Brien? What? I don't understand.
Okay. You were there. That night. Farewell. The next time,
Nero Protocol 2-7 states.
Everyone was dead. They were slaughtered, torn limb for goddamn limb. All right, listen up. We're going to do this the easy way or the hard way. The easy way, we have a little chat. You give me the information that I need, and then you go back to digging your way through freaker shit or whatever the hell else you're doing out here. The hard way. I crack open that little space suit, and then we see what your friends out there have to say about you breathing in all this contaminated air. So what's it going to be, O'Brien?
Yes. Okay. Okay.
You remember the rooftop of the old brewery? I put a woman on your chopper. She was wounded.
Yes. I remember. A knife wound. She was cut pretty bad.
I went to the refugee camp that you said you were taking her to. Everyone was dead. So I'm going to ask you again. How did you survive?
We weren't there. We were diverted south to another camp. Like you said, Camp in Belknap was overrun, so They moved us south to a camp outside of Silver Lake.
Were there survivors?
You mean now? I don't know. I was transferred to the research unit.
Did she survive?
Oh, wait. I can find out. I can check. You have one of our radios. That's how you... I can't promise anything, but I'll check.
Uh-huh, and I'm gonna go with you.
No, you can't, please. You don't... Hey, you don't understand. I'll fucking shoot you.
Not before I shoot you.
Okay, look, if you're gonna fucking kill me, do it, okay? I did my job. Did that woman, your wife... I put her on oxygen. I gave her an IV. I kept her alive. I got in a lot of trouble for that. She was septic. She wasn't gonna make it, but I got her to the mass unit. I saved her goddamn life!
O'Brien, report.
I have to go. Please, you have to get out of here. You don't know these men. You don't know
O'Brien,
what they're capable of.
If I don't hear from you, I don't care how long it takes, I'm going to track you down. And I'm going to do a lot worse than snap off an antenna.
I'm sorry about your wife. But you're not the only one who lost someone that night.
He alive. They were diverted south. He said that he put her on oxygen. He gave her an IV. He kept her alive. She was septic, so she wasn't gonna make it, but he got her to a mass unit. He saved her life. He said it. He said he saved her life. She can still be. She. No. But O'Brien is alive. And if he is. Man, a few days ago, I asked you if you remembered that Nero asshole, O'Brien.
Yeah, Deke, it's all kind of a blur.
Yeah, okay. Get some shut-eye, booze man. I'll tell you about it later.
When are we riding out of here, Deke?
Soon, Boozer. Real soon. Look, as soon as your arm heals, we're gonna be riding the hell out of here.
Yeah, Deke.
O'Brien. Are you out there? O'Brien! Oh, you son of a bitch, you better radio me. You hear me, O'Brien? You're on this channel. God damn it. You better get back to me or I'm going to track you down. You got that? Oh, God damn it. Oh, come on! O'Brien! Get back to me.
Track down the chopper. Was it the same guy, the one we saw on the roof that night?
Yeah. Yeah, it was him.
And did he remember us? Sarah, what happened?
I don't know. They got diverted south. He remembered her, but he doesn't know what happened to her.
You don't think she's still alive?
What? No. I mean, no. Look, I'm not stupid, Boozer. I just want to find out, you know, what happened to her. Where she died.
Some peace.
I don't need to find any peace, Jesus, Boozer. I gotta go, all right? Deacon out.
Wow. Well, I am glad that I went ahead and followed whatever that story was, because we were at like 40 minutes and we did the side mission, and I thought, oh, maybe I'll just start making shorter videos and I'll just make this video be specifically this mission. But they're crossing, so, you know, you're never really going to get one full thing. But I'm glad I went and continued on for that other story mission. I guess it was a side mission, finding the You're Safe Now mission. But I'm glad I tracked down that chopper. I don't know why. Let me see. Okay, it's not there now. I don't know why I kept getting that survival tip just sitting there above the dialogue. That's why during the dialogue I went to the map real quick and then went out of it when I was first approaching them and I was hiding in the river. I switched to the map real quick and then back out because I didn't want to interrupt the dialogue too much and break that pacing. But I just didn't. Survival hint was driving me nuts. So, wow, this is, again, I am really happy with this story so far. I'm following it. There was a lot of information, and I'm glad I'm streaming my videos because I can go back and watch what I missed. And of course, I could do that with someone else's video, but, you know, I don't want to be watching them going and doing something that I haven't done yet. I don't want anything to be spoiled. I want to be able to go back and see what I missed without having anything else in the game that's happening be spoiled. So, but aside from that, I'm really impressed with the story so far. I like this mystery. I'm surprised they're already telling us that, oh, she was moved to another camp. I feel like that's a big reveal. It seems fairly early on. I don't think I'm rushing through this story. It can't be that short of a story that we're just going to get to this other camp and there she will be. Or maybe there she will be, but there'll be some other issues to take care of. I don't know. And there's quite a lot of freakers all over the place. My God. I guess I drove through that. There was tons. It seemed like I drove somewhere else. It seemed like there's more than just these two spots. There's just so many nests. So what I might do in the next video is clear out these nests, because I'll get points. I'll get experience points. Yeah, there's a lot of them there. Good Lord. I wonder if, like, the longer you don't do it, the more that come out, because they're everywhere. My gosh. And there was that one horde by... Is it here? Well, I guess not, because that's cleared out. There's something that I drove through that was very... There's the train. So, yeah, that's a narrow checkpoint. I don't know why I can fast travel there. There's still a, there was still that speaker that I tried to, when I drove through there and I saw that the freakers weren't there in that area, I thought maybe I'd have time to quickly jump off my bike and jump on the roof and cut it and get back on the bike and go, but that big pile of freakers came from around up here and came running out. So maybe when I try to come back, I'll park my bike over here and see if I can sneak up. Because I know they say that, you know, sounds can be heard and all that stuff. So, yeah, I don't know why this says this is... Or I'll just... No, fast traveling doesn't matter, because the bike will still be making noise when the game loads me in there. So I'll drive it up and pop it there somewhere. Because there's freakers everywhere, my gosh. This seems like a really, really, really big horde. I don't know how I'm going to take care of all of these guys, but at least I can turn off the speaker. And I hope to upgrade. Can I upgrade how much ammo I can carry? There's like a satchel I can throw on the bike. I didn't see that as an option at Tucker's camp, but I guess they just offer, in terms of the bike, they just offer the ability to fuel and fix the bike. They don't offer parts. I'd have to go to here, Copeland's camp, where they will have bike upgrades. But I'll do that in the next video. Do I have any experience points? Any new experience points? No skill points. Okay. And I like, because this is a Sony exclusive, so I guess Sony really wants to make sure that they design this game around the controller as much as possible, and they're really using this touchscreen, the swiping. I was playing Borderlands, and I know you could press that to bring up your backpack and everything, press the big button, but it's nice to be able to have these swiping gestures, too. I'll have to go back and see what other games allow for swiping gestures. Okay, so those are my thoughts. I'm still very impressed with the game. I do see the glitches here and there, like a zombie popping up out of nowhere, or like when I killed the bear, I was just sort of standing in the middle of it, and you know, things kind of, you kick over a bucket and the bucket's jerking around all crazy. I cut off that one freaker's head, and you kind of, because you see a severed head roll, and then you also see the head of the freaker still attached, so there was two freakers. Whatever, you know. Those are small potatoes. And yeah, so, okay. Glad I got this video done. See you guys in the next one for video number 7. Bye-bye.